Now you listen to me real good. I've told you once, I said it 1,000 times. You get out of those pagan, satanic, religious, Christian churches. Christians do not follow the commandments of the Bible. Christians do what they want to do. They make up their own laws, their own rules, and their own regulations. Come out of her, my people, and come out from among them. And it's real simple and easy to ascertain who are these people you need to come out from. Easy. Number one, if they keep Sunday, that's an automatic sign that you need to not have any fellowship with these commandment-breaking, wicked deceivers and seducers and bewitchers of the truth. Simple.
It's good to be in the land of living, isn't it? Hey, Brother Dawg, come here, bro. Take this thing all the way to the back there, all right? Abba Yah, we do thank you for all things. You alone are worthy of all praise, glory, and honor. You called us out to bring us in. And we're asking you to bring us into your truth and your word this morning to bring about a people that will glorify your name and that will magnify your name amongst the nations. Father, watch over Israel, no matter where they be, in the hour that we're living in. We know that the time of tribulation is upon us. We need your strength. We need your protecting. We need your power. Watch over us, and we will magnify your name. Hopefully that this last assembly will be greater than the first. We thank you for the blood of Yahshua, in the magnificent name of Yahshua. Hallelujah. You may be seated. All right, come on, Sister Ashley. Ah. Okay, I figured out what that was, Elder Doug. If we have that mic sitting right here, if Deacon Bell sets that mic up right here, if I don't move that thing, that's what's causing all that heavy feedback. So I have to move it back here. That's what it is. So if I get caught up in a playing a guitar and it's got that feedback, just do some wave signals or something like that. It'll wake me up. Y'all all right?
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah. Nice to be in the land of the living, isn't it? All right. Of course, everybody loves this part. We got letters. You know, the letters are there for edification, exhortation, and comfort. They're a teaching tool. We don't call the names because it's not important. What's important is the questions that they have and some of the things that they're going through, knowing that there's no temptation except that which is common to man.
Yes, sir.
Is that right?
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah. Come on, Sister Ashley.
Shabbat Shalom, my brother, my pastor, Dow. I'm over here, but I wish me and my wife could be with you, brothers and sisters living in Straightway, and work for Israel and worship Yahalah together every Shabbat and every day. I'm interested in knowing who this other person is who calls Jesus Messiah for Yashio Mashiach. That person is probably an Assyrian. If possible, and if this person has nothing against to make themselves known than to me and my wife, it would be happy, and we would be happy to know them. Because as for now, Yah has us alone in Sweden in Straightway and following our King Yashio Mashiach, and we will be happy to know of others here, nearby in Sweden, who have the faith and do not forsake the word. Thank you for the calendar on Straightway site. I would want to donate to you through PayPal, and I have an account there that I trust. May Yashio Mashiach bless you, Pastor Down Straightway, and enjoy your Shabbat.
I don't have a PayPal, but Sister Carol does in her business. You can probably go that route and go that way. I'll send you the information by way of email. I'm hoping that I don't have two people the same in one. Does that make any sense? I know that's not proper English, right? What do you expect? I've been taken from my culture, robbed from my land. So if I talk and I don't use proper English, you're going to have to forgive me. Is that all right?
Yes, sir.
All right. I mean, I don't know how much more nicer you can be. All right, go ahead to the next one.
Ask your question here, it says. Pastor, can you explain the new covenant for me? I don't understand. The Most High says he changes not, but I thought we were under the covenant we made with the Most High at Mount Sinai. Can you explain this to me or point me to a video? You already answered this question. Thank you for reading my note.
Shalom. I'm not going to take long on this. Brother Shane, go to Jeremiah 31:31. We'll just read that verse, and that would let you know what the new covenant is. Isn't that right? We're full of religious dogma. You know, that somebody say old covenant, new covenant, you think that they're separating covenants. You follow me? If you have an old car and you're restored, that would be a new car now, wouldn't it? I mean, I understand what we're up against, though. You follow me? We've had a hill to climb. You know, we've been literally waging war against false teachings and doctrines and everything else that's got our mind all turned upside down. And read Jeremiah 31:31, Brother Shane.
Behold,
woo,
the days come, saith Yahweh, that I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel.
So the new covenant, he's going to make a new covenant with the same old people. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
Yahweh sent Israel, right? Yes. So he's going to make a new covenant with the same old people. He says he's going to make a new covenant with the house of Israel. Let's see what that new covenant is, okay?
And with the house of Judah.
And with the house of Judah.
Not according to the covenant that I made with their fathers in the day that I took them by the hand to bring them out of the land of Egypt.
Now, when he did that covenant, what he did was he took two tables of stone and he wrote them with the finger of Yah. You'll read about that. All right? Finger, not handwriting. People go to Colossians and get it mixed up, blotting out the handwriting. So, you know, Christianity with his antinomianism and stuff want to just do away with everything. But he didn't do away with the finger writing. That's what Yah wrote. He didn't write the 10 suggestions either. He didn't ask you if it was okay for you to do them or not either. He wrote commandments. Read.
Which my covenant they broke.
Now Israel broke the covenant. How did they break the covenant? Somebody say rebellious.
Rebellious.
Disobedient.
Disobedient.
Stubborn.
Stubborn.
Stiff-necked.
Stiff-necked.
Stout-hearted.
Stout-hearted.
Ain't that you? Can you imagine, here's the creator of the universe. He says, okay, you're my people. I've taken you from all the nations of the earth and made sure that I've chosen you out from the nation of the earth to make sure that you are my people and exclusively mine alone. So I got something for you. I got great laws, great commandments, and great statutes. You know the reason why? Because you are a great people. And then you know what we said? And we're still doing that today, too. Some of us. Because Joshua and Caleb didn't give the Most High the middle. There was a righteous seed amongst Israel. That's what we're trying to get over us today. There is a righteous seed amongst Israel. Because not everybody that say that they're what? Israel is what?
Israel.
Just because you say you Israel, that don't mean nothing. That don't mean nothing at all. Read on.
Although I was a husband unto them.
He was a what? A husband to Israel and Judah. That means Yahweh had two wives. Two wives. Read on.
Saith Yahweh. But this shall be the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel.
All right. This is the covenant. This is the covenant. Watch this.
After those days, saith Yahweh, I will put my law.
Oh, stop. The same thing that he wrote with his finger. Tablets of stone. And the same thing he gave Moses. He said he's going to read that again. He's going to do what?
I will put my laws in their inward parts.
Oh, so he didn't do away with it then. So he took what was on stone and what was on parchment and put it here. That's how I know if you're really truly Israel or not. Because there's a lot of people saying that they're Israel, but you're not Israel. You act just like these Goyims out here. If you really truly is born again, you don't even have to know the law, but the spirit that is in you will automatically obey it. See, a lot of this stuff that you got problems with today, this little mischief, inconsistencies, you know, we dress them up. We don't call them sins, iniquities, and transgressions. That's what they really truly are. We dress them up. Issues, troubles, problems, emotional disorders, no, sins, iniquities, and transgressions. And all of those are just responses for your iniquity. You know, if you behave a certain way, you're going to act a certain way. And you suffer. When you obey the law, you're at peace. So he's going to take the law off the stones and put it in your inward parts. Read.
And write it in their hearts.
He's going to write it on your hearts.
And will be their Elohim.
Then he will be your Elohim. Then he will be your Yah. Y'all get it? So this thing y'all call born again, where you say a few words of repentance, you drop a few tears, if you do that nowadays. You know, the people in Ezra day was astonished when they had the law read to them from morning to evening. They said, man, you mean to tell me we have gotten that far off? We have gotten that far off? It smote their hearts. Rent their garments. It's like, oh man, what do we do? See, that's start of repentance right there. See, at the inception of knowing how much you have missed the mark and transgressed, it breaks your heart. And it causes you to say, I am sorry. Father, I'm sorry for the way that I live. See, you ignorant today because you've been through all these slaveries and you don't forgot who you were. You don't forgot who you are. And so now we try to tell you who you are, and then all of a sudden you have a moment of righteousness, and then when you choose to obey Yah, you do pretty good. But as soon as that flesh rises up and tempts again, you go back to Goyimism, being a Gentile. So 1 minute you're Israel, next minute you're Gentile. 1 minute you're Israel, next minute you're Gentile. You have to loathe your condition and realize that you're offending the creator of the universe, especially as his chosen people. Because godly sorrow worketh repentance, right? What's the next part? Not to be repented of again. You repent, you go repeat. You repent, you go repeat. You repent, you go repeat, and you think y'all stupid as hell. And when you're giving over to your sin, and there's no peace, your health is failing, you have anxiety, you have problems, social problems, stigmas, your emotions you can't make sense of, you don't realize that that's y'all's on you. There's no peace to the wicked. That's his whooping post for you. Somebody need to tell you. See, used to, if you were transgressing Israel, we would say, okay, good, we get you go, okay, I got it. Okay, good, we glad that you have it. Now we have to finish our judgment. Yeah, get up here and lay down. Oh, well, what are you finna get ready to do? Well, we're going to cane you. Oh, cane me? Yeah, because, you know, when we put these stripes on your back, you're going to remember for sure that you don't want to come back here no more. But here in America, oh, I'm sorry, and then you go back and do it again. No judgment for punishment. So Yah says, don't worry about it, since we moved from that which is natural over to spiritual. I'll just give you over to emotional disorders. Many of you haven't even been diagnosed yet. But you have mental illnesses. It's spiritually retarded the way some of you act. Y'all hear me on the other side of that camera? Yeah, that's a social disorder and a mental disorder for transgression. Sad part about it is you become so accustomed to functioning that way that nobody can tell you nothing now. If a person is given over to a reprobate mind, what are you going to say to convince them? You got to realize where they at and go, you know what, I got to leave this alone. If y'all's not dealing with them, there ain't nothing I can do. Uh-oh. So you better take heed to yourselves. That you don't take these laws lightly. Read on.
And they shall be my people.
See, then you'll be his people and he will be your Elohim. Obedience is better than sacrifice. To hearken is better than the fat of rams. If my people which are called after my name will humble themselves and pray and do what? Seek my face. You don't seek nobody's face. You don't seek y'all's face. Where is y'all at? Most of y'all ask you where y'all is, you do like this. If I ask you where is y'all, so who you praying to, the sun, the moon, or the stars? Y'all also said in his new covenant that he was going to dwell with you and he shall be in you. That's where y'all is. Y'all don't dwell in his building. He dwells in a house that wasn't made with hands. And what we've gotten so used to living in this world, we forgot that wherever we go, no matter what we do, y'all's there. See, if you knew that, and the law was written on the tables of your heart, how much sneaking and iniquity, tiptoeing and transgressing would you do then, knowing that he's right there? That's how I know many of you don't have the Ruach. I hear people say it all the time. How do these people get away with that? They ain't getting away with it. You don't want their life, I promise you. The mental oppression is off the chain. No peace to the wicked. What you want to do is you want to keep yourselves in the good graces of the Most High. Dawid said, I will do what? Where? That I. What's that word? The same covenant. They got off a parchment off a stone right here. So now you understand what it means. You don't have no need of any man teaching. Because that law is already there. See, if you're away from us, you're not going to use that as an opportunity to go sin. Because then you're saying man is your God. If I'm not around, y'all should be able to keep you. Uh-oh. If you have to act a certain way, you're around me. And when you're away from me, you act totally different. Then you're trying to get me in trouble because I ain't your God. Did I say something wrong? Ain't that how some of us do? We get around the saints. We change our behavior and attitude and everything. As soon as we leave, greater is he that is than he that is. Isn't that something? You forget. And then we'll sing the old songs of Zion. Where he leads me, I will follow. So he led you to the whorehouse, right? So he led you to the drug house, right? Huh? So he led you to go sin, right? He's in you. See, you're liars. And the truth ain't in you. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. I ain't worried about it. Brother Eric, he loves his part. Read on.
And they shall teach no more every man his neighbor.
Mm-hmm.
And every man his brother.
What? Why? Come on.
Saying, know Yahweh.
I can't teach you to know Yah. You already know him. He's supposed to be in you if you're Israel, right?
Right.
Read on.
For they shall all know me.
From what?
From the least of them to the greatest.
To the what?
Of all them.
So don't tell me you don't know Yah. You do like these polytheistic people do. You got a God for everything. Then you have the same attitude as the Gentiles. Whenever you want to use Yah, you pick them up, put them in your heart. When you don't, you pick up your other peg and God put it in your heart. Y'all don't see what's going on, it's so clear. All right, let's go on with the letters. Hope you got that.
Subject outside of straightway is not so grand.
Oh, wait. Subject outside of what?
Straightway.
Straightway. Do y'all know how many times the word straightway is in the Bible? It's all out there. It's spelled two different ways, too. There's even a way called straight. Come on.
Shalom.
I want y'all to hear this one because, see, this is what happens when you say that you listen to us and then you go do your own little thing. Watch this. And this is an older person, old enough to be your mama.
Shalom. I got impatient and I put an ad on Craigslist.
Got impatient and put an ad on Craigslist. You get that? Read.
I met a heathen and I moved in with him.
Now, what does the law say about that? Be not unequally yoked together with unbelievers. Is that a suggestion? Or is that a protection that's trying to protect us? Is that right? Is that right? Huh? And you can't tell me you haven't heard that listening to me. Oh, come on now. Huh? All right. Met a heathen. Moved in.
He made me choose between him and straightway. And
made me choose between him. You didn't choose between him and straightway. You chose between him and Yah. Watch this.
Like a fool, I chose him.
Isn't that something? Now, how can this go good? How can this go good? Watch this.
Come to find out, he is a white supremacist.
Whoa, he's a white supremacist.
And hates niggers.
And he hates niggers. I hate niggers too. Niggers. Is that N-I-G-G-E-R-S?
E-R-S.
You got to say ers.
Hates niggers.
Niggers. Isn't that something?
Yes, sir.
Hate niggers, so that means he hate himself. Uh-oh. He don't even have enough intelligence to say he hate Negroes. Read on.
And will never believe Yeshua is black.
So? Sound like a personal problem to me.
After a month and a half, he informed me he has hepatitis C.
Ooh! See what's happening for transgression? Do you see what's happening for transgression? Y'all see it? Stepping out. You hear that? He informed me after they've been in the boudoir. Brother Saint, Exodus 15, 26. Y'all getting this? You would think, especially being somewhere in late 50s, early 60s, that you would learn. Just life in general would have matured you. Hold one sec. Read.
And said. If you. Will diligently.
Diligently do what?
Hearken to the voice of Yahweh thy Elohim.
If you hearken to the voice. King James Version said, Lord thy God. Come on.
And will do that which is right in his sight.
Do that which is right in whose sight?
His
sight. But what we do today, that which is right in our sight. And then we want to call it his sight. That's why we appointed a portion with the hypocrites. Read.
And will give ear to his commandments.
You hear that? And give ear to his. Watch what he said. Come on.
And keep all his statutes.
Keep how many of his statutes?
All.
Come on.
I will put none of these diseases.
Stop. He will put none of these what?
Diseases.
Diseases. Did Jesus heal people of diseases?
Yes.
You know, the one thing I never discuss in this ministry right here, I never talk about in the open. What I do is give a blanket statement like this. Huh? Within the last 4 years, we have had 6 people healed, if not more, from incurable sexual diseases. I don't parade them up here, you know, because with their doctor's verification, just so you can gloat over it. I mean, really. I mean, incurable. That's what the world says. From AIDS, herpes, gonorrhea. I'm serious. I ain't gonna show you the doctor's verification just so I can prove it. So Jesus is still healing then. All I did was just use Jesus. That's what he told me to do. He said, son, I'm in you. You're preaching. Now I told you to go heal the sick. And that healing of the sick was supposed to bring people close to Yah. That's the ideal of it. Because the Pharisees, the scribes, no man can do this work like Jesus can. So I get doctor's verification sent to me and everything. Just a beautiful thing. You know what they get to do then? You can tell they really truly have met Yah's conditions. Because when they repented, are you following? When you receive salvation, you're delivered. And you're made every whit whole. He forgive you of your sins of the past. Oh, it's a brand new concept, isn't it? Isn't that amazing? So here's someone that says, I know what the book says, but, see, I told you, women have desires just like men do. Now here's a case where a woman is looking for a man. They always want to top men with lust. Ain't nothing wrong with lust as long as it's right. If all my wives pull their panties off, I'm lusting.
That's
right. See, effeminate men, they can't understand that. They eyes get all goo-gooed for a transgender. And you women in trouble today. Because, man, these men that are dressing up, Sister Nellie the other day, not too long ago, showed me a picture. She said, look at that. And I said, yeah. She said, what is that? I said, it's a woman. She said, uh-uh. I said, see the reason why I say stay among your people? You got transgenders out here looking better than women. Women, if y'all don't shut your mouth and cover y'all behind, y'all gonna be finished. Just by regular, off the top of our heads, statistics again, all right? War, look how many wars we got going on in this world. The male population is already being decimated by war. Is it not? There's a higher birth rate among females than there is men. Is that correct? We got two of them so far, right? We got two of them. And then drugs is taking people out left and right, taking especially men. Is that right? There's three of them. Is that all right? Then you have suicide. Whoo! And then you have gang-related violence. We're up to five already. Y'all hearing this? And then we got those who are choosing to be sodomites. Alternative lifestyle, they call it today. Y'all getting this? Am I making any sense? We at 6-1 already right now. That's just on that alone. 6-1. Six females to every one man. And then we got those who are incarcerated. Seven. And already in the world, the women are outnumbering the men. 8. Just one thing to be born, but what do you do with all this? Look at this stuff. I guess that's the reason why you got to get on Craigslist. You're not going to find a good man on Craigslist. And what is a woman doing looking for a man anyway? Well, Pastor Dow, you said, yeah, I know what I said, and I know my intent and why I said it. I told you what's happening, and you don't want to admit it, but I'm going to say it again, and I'm going to use these superlatives too. Y'all's doing this thing right now that all the shitty women get the shitty men, and all the good women get the good men. That's what's happening. See, we don't like to admit that is our state, though. I mean, you've been listening to me, following the ministry, all this time. Should have made yourself known, came around. There's a bunch of old men that would love to have a good wife, but you know, you can't have a good wife if you ain't no good. That's why you got to go to Craigslist. What section do you put that under in Craigslist? Ratchet? Ratchet? Huh? Huh?
Persons.
Ratchet persons. Ratchet rusty. Go back a little bit. Go back to right here and read.
Right here?
No. Second, yeah, right there. Sorry, right there.
Come to find out, he is a white supremacist and hates niggers and will never believe Yeshua is black. After a month and a half, he informed me he has hepatitis C. He also likes bondage, and I refuse to do anal sex with him.
Boy, we are baptized into death, God. We are straight up baptized into death. Give me sin, death, hell, and the devil. See. That's what happened to us when we wouldn't obey Yah, and he put us into captivity all these nations. That's why he has to fight like hell to even get even the people. Your mind is so far gone. In every generation, Yah has always raised up faithful men. He's always done. You can read it to you until you're green in the face. You always see them. People who are doing anything, mind their own business, and all of a sudden, boom. See, can't nobody be faithful because you look through the lenses of your eyes. That's why ain't nobody else no good, because you ain't no good. Read on.
I live in a double wide with almost no heat. He drinks basically almost every night and all morning, afternoon, and night on the weekends. I keep seeing straightway everywhere. A sister came to my house to buy a table. And then a week later, I saw two sisters in Goodwill and Gallatin, where I now live.
Straightway everywhere. You know what y'all's doing, right? Bringing conviction on that wicked heart. Showing you what you are missing and what you in. That means this person is close. Read on.
I still believe the prophecy I shared with you.
They probably see y'all and then just look at you because they know who you are. But then don't say nothing. Can't say nothing. Too much shame. Read.
I still believe the prophecy I shared with you is correct, and that O will stay in power from behind the scenes. I can't go back to Florida because I still believe a tsunami will hit. I have a job interview in Nashville tomorrow, if I get the job.
I bet that lazy ass nigger ain't working. Well, you won't bet. Niggers don't work. Ain't that right, nigger? Make sure he's watching this. Because if you watching, I'm going to put you probably off. Make sure that nigger hears me. I don't even sound right saying it like that. You do. Huh? Come on.
If I get the job, I can rent a room somewhere. Also, my disability got approved, but I'm only getting $736 a month, and it will be months before I see any money at all. I hope you can forgive me for leaving and the things that I said. Please pray for me. I need it. I love you. Shalom.
Well, I seek from forgiveness from me. I'm not the one you're transgressing against. Are y'all hearing this?
Oh, yeah.
See, I know and I realize that we preach. Paul ran up against the same thing. He actually dedicated a whole chapter based on his demeanor. Because people didn't think that he was nice enough. Said his speech was contemptible. And said that he always threatened people. And then I had somebody, and I know they're watching. They accused me of being a separatist cult. And you know what I said to them? I said, thank you. Thank you very much. Glad I am. You get it?
Yes, sir.
So let me see. This is the reason why we are cult. All right? We are cult because we teach our own people to buy their own land. It's a pretty good cult, isn't it? And we build our own communities. Y'all get that? See, what these hypocrites don't understand is that we don't want to be like the world. You get it? We used to be in the world. We don't want to be like the world. And we don't want to live like they do. We don't want to do like they do. We don't want to eat unclean animals such as pig and frogs and snakes and dogs and lizards and sea maggots. Y'all know that Christians are bottom feeders? They are. They bottom feeders. You don't believe me? Ask them. What fish that stays at the bottom of the lake that they love eating? Catfish, see? They bottom feeders. This spirit of anti-Messiah is working really hard. It's vying for your attention. We live in a nation that champions itself as what they call a Christian nation. They carry around the Bible and all this stuff, but they don't believe a word that's in it. All these churches, preachers, got a lot of money. They have a lot of money. Some of them got 3-4 homes, yachts, jets. People sitting right down in that congregation, starving. That's what Jesus would do, right? See, we ain't never had a lot of money. But I ask you a question, which one would you rather have? Money or wisdom? See, we under this false paradigm that we need money. No, what you need is wisdom. So you know how to be content with what you have. And so you'll know how to maximize what you have with wisdom. Isn't that right? Proverbs 24, verse 3, Brother Shane, read. Listen to the book.
Through wisdom is an house built.
Y'all hear that? Through wisdom is a house what?
Built.
Come on.
And by understanding, it is established.
So let me see. I don't have the money that a lot of these people have always had. These people have had millions upon millions of dollars. Are you following me? So let me show you something. Through wisdom, in this ministry right here, we have a combined 154 acres that we own. No note. Don't owe nobody nothing. Through wisdom, we built 6 communities. 6 of them. Through wisdom, We have 12 home fellowships, United States of America, Canada, and overseas. That's through wisdom. And we're few. So which one would you rather have, wisdom or money? See, you can have all the money in the world and not have wisdom and do nothing. Better it is with a little that a man has. Uh-oh. Huh? These people got a lot of money but don't have wisdom. Uh-oh. So which one would you rather have? Wisdom is the principal thing, isn't it? 1 Corinthians 16:19, Brother Shane. Watch this. You see, through wisdom, we've learned to make sure that our people come out of these churches and get into the house. Read 1 Corinthians 16:19, Brother Shane.
The churches of Asia salute you. Aquila and Priscilla salute you much in Yahweh. With the church that is in their house.
Where's the church at?
In their house.
Colossians 4:15.
Salute the brethren which are in Laodicea,
mm-hmm,
and Nymphos, and the church which is in his house.
Where's the church at?
His house.
Philemon 1:2.
And to our beloved Apphia, and Archippus, our fellow soldier, and to the church in thy house.
Where's the, all these the churches at?
House.
In the house, huh? Why take money you go out and work for and then pay a hefty tithe and offering and give it to some building that you're not going to benefit from? Why not just use wisdom and put it into a place where Yah is dwelling, which is in the house? Oh, I know, we're cold, ain't we? So far, we're doing a whole lot better than you. See, these people claim they got wisdom and they got debt. And I mean a bunch of it, too. You getting this? And, you know, the book teaches us that we should separate from you people. So I believe in separatism. I do. I believe we should stay as far away from this world as possible. That's what makes us a cult. Isn't that amazing? Now, Revelations 18:4, read, Brother Shane. Listen to what the book said at the end of it right here.
And I heard another voice from heaven saying,
do what?
Come out of her, my people.
Why do you want to come out of her?
That ye be not partaker of her sins.
See, we don't want to be a part of your sinful life. Your iniquitous ways and your transgressions. We don't want to be a part of that. So we obey Yah and we come out. Isn't that beautiful?
Yes, sir.
And when we come out of her, we also come out from among you. We don't want to be around sausage eaters. Bacon lovers. Maggot eaters. What's wrong with that? That's the reason why we come out. We come out so we can build our own communities. So we'll know who our neighbor is. We want to be around people who are just like us. We just assumed that all of Israel came out of Mizraim. No, it didn't. The majority of them did, but a lot of them, they loved Egypt. And there was Egyptians that wasn't doing too good in Egypt and said, you know what, I'm going with these Israelites. And there was other people that heard what was going on. And they said, man, I don't know who these people are, but man, they God is cutting a fool on this earth. I'm going with them. Yeah, and the mixed multitude came up. Huh? 2 Corinthians 6:17-18, Brother Shane. Listen to the book.
Wherefore, come out from among them.
Don't the Bible teach us come out? That's why we don't have our children in your public schools. Because we're coming out. We don't want them to be introduced to sodomites. Isn't that beautiful?
Yes, sir.
We don't want their teacher to be witches or dykes and bull daggers or men having trouble identifying who they are or what they are. We don't need that confusion. So we just choose to obey the book. Read.
And be ye separate.
See? Mosiah Yah commands us to be what?
Separate.
Isn't that something? So if we're a cult for obeying Yah, hallelujah. I'll be the best cult in the world. Glory to the King. I like this separate stuff. You look at all the men, and I think these are great men. You look at Martin Luther King and Louis Farrakhan. What have they done for their people? They always talk about segregation and being separate. What does these Hebrew camps talk about? They always talk about come out, but they say come out from the white man. And they coming out, and they still got their ass stuck right up there smack dab in the city under the white man. These people don't believe what they're saying. They're just policing the people. Sin ain't got no color to it. Uh-oh. So the mixed multitude, we obey, we come out. Three.
And be ye separate, saith Yahweh, and touch not the unclean thing.
Touch not the what?
The unclean thing.
And then look what he says.
And I will receive you.
You hear that?
Yes.
That's based on conditions. You don't touch the unclean things, he said, then I will receive you. But before that, you got to put one foot in front of another and start obeying. You're not going to give his mental assent junk. By wisdom. Isn't that something? The wisdom of Yah is wiser than this wicked world. Even his foolishness is wiser than the wisdom of this wicked world. And look what the instruction book, same instruction book they carry. The difference is we obey and they don't. Read.
And will be a father unto you.
See, when you meet all these conditions and do what he says, then he said he will be a what?
Father
unto you. Come on.
And ye shall be my sons and daughters.
Y'all hear that? Yep, when you meet these conditions, then you will be his sons and daughters. Read on.
Saith Yahweh Almighty.
See, we're a holy nation. Royal priesthood. That's what we are. Go to Exodus 12, 37, 38. Listen to this.
And the children of Israel journeyed from Ramesses to Succoth, about 600,000 on foot that were men beside children. And a mixed multitude went up also with them, and flocks and herds, even very much cattle.
You know, do y'all realize you don't see too many set apart congregations like us that is mixed and diverse as we are? But mixed multitude. Coming out. Isn't that amazing? Coming out. Now, should we let the world teach our children or should we teach our children? The greatest teacher to the children is mother. Uh-oh. Yeah, mother. Proverbs 22, verse 6. Read.
Train up a child in the way he should go.
If we send them out there in the world, they're going to get confused. As soon as they go into your public school, they're going to know which bathroom to go in. See, a school teacher, you thinking that it's straight up a man, but it's a woman. That's confusion. Because if our children was to come around your school system and see some of these effeminate men, they come home and ask us questions. Daddy, I saw a man, but he act like a woman. What is that? And of course, you know, I'm a father, just tell the children like it is. You know that stuff that come out your ass? That's what they are, shit lovers. And they will say, that's nasty, Dad. I say, you got to say it again, nasty. With your nasty ass. See, they won't be confused with me. Because I'll tell them straight up. I say, see that one? That's a woman. See, she got these things that you sucked on when you was a baby. That's the reason why you don't go around today falling out all over the place looking at women's breasts. Because you had enough of it when you was a child. Oh, boy. See, that's a woman, her voice is not as deep as ours. She's not as strong as we are. You know what I mean? She look better than we do. You know what I mean? Carry themselves different. See, they won't be confused when they hear me. Well, I don't like your speech. I don't like your culture. We had a bad problem then, ain't we? I promise ain't no child here confused. They are. We'll knock the confusion right out of them. Oh, hallelujah. A boy know what a boy, and he know what he was created for. A girl know the girl. First thing you do when you come out of your mother's womb, the first thing you do is they look down. They don't look at you and try to identify what you are. They look down. Oh, boy. I wonder how you knew that. Now today they're telling us, well, you don't know if that's a boy or not. You've got to wait till they get to like 4 or 5 years old and let them determine who or what they're going to be. You just as retarded as the... That's what they're pushing today. They're pushing that today. Right on the front cover of National Geographic, they had this ugly looking boy that had pink hair. I'm so glad I know what I am now. See, this is what they're trying to force us to accept. And see, when they have preachers out there talking like this, they're trying to silence our mouths. They're trying to censor us because they want a culture of liberalism. You're your own being. You exist for yourself. You're your own God. You have no rules except what you pick and choose for life. And they get mad at us for standing on this. And see, and we have to talk like this because that's how vile their spirit is. You've got to talk like this in this wicked and perverse generation. How you think the prophets talk? Like Joel Osteen? Are you serious? Earl Polk? Benny Hinn? The prophets look just like Benny Hinn. Our children ain't growing up confused. Read Joshua 1:8, brother Shane.
This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein.
Y'all hear that?
Yes, sir.
That's supposed to be your meditation. You keep his book in front of you, man, I'm telling you, it's gonna change your heart. Read on.
For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous.
How do you make your way prosperous? By having the law in you. And what else?
And then shalt thou have good success.
You'll have good success. So we got a world today, there are people out there, they got yachts, they got boats, they got homes, and they don't own none of it. I'd rather have a quarter acre of land with old raggedy trailer on it. At least I can say that Yah's blessed is rich and don't add me no sorrow. I mean, I got a roof over my head. What more do you need? What, they got a TV? You got a TV. Yours probably this big, theirs is this big. What's the big deal? You still got a TV. You really don't need one. They got a car, you got a car. They paid $100,000, you paid $2,000. you know, one extreme to the other. It's better when a man have a little. And these people, I mean, Donald Trump, he's a billionaire, right? All right, tell him to pay all his debts with all the billions he got and see how much money he got. Do y'all know that this country that we live in, do you know that this country really, truly does not exist? Look at him looking at me now. No, Pastor, it does exist. I know. Where are you at right now? What country are you in? See, now nobody don't want to answer. You want to be wise guys now. Y'all want to be wise guys now. If America was its own country, first and foremost, it would have its own money supply. It wouldn't need the Federal Reserve. Never mind. We'll go on, man. We wouldn't have to go in hot to borrow from the Rothschilds, the Bilderbergers. Am I telling the truth, all you men that know economics? Why we got to go and borrow money from Federal Reserve, the Federal Reserve? If we was our own country, America would have its own money. And we so broke, we got to go borrow money from other countries. We owe China trillions of dollars. So we're not a country, we are a corporation. Why do you think Donald Trump is doing so good? He knows how to run business. CEO of a corporation. We got to trim the waste. Trim the fat. Get rid of the pork. I try my best. The Father knows I try my best to talk to us. See, what happens is you look at this stupid man up here and you go, that can't be a man of y'all. But you are then, right? We're owned by the bankers. Who was that? Was that not Rothschild said, I don't care who you have. It's puppets running this country. You just give me control of the money supply. That's a bold statement. See, when we had just weights and balances, silver and gold, we had our own money supply. We had the wealth, and nations were borrowing from us. Then all of a sudden, somebody flipped the script. We was the greatest creditor nation. Now we're the greatest debtor nation. As dumb as I am, I know this. And you be up there with Lee Greenwood. And this boot lick itself. I'm proud to be a, let me revise the song. I'm proud to be a broke ass American. By wisdom. And this world wants you to come and participate in its social system. And y'all is teaching us come out from the system. And you want to go into it. Y'all is teaching us to be separate, and you're trying to hold one foot in Israel and the other foot in the world. Look at us as a people. He's trying to free us. And look what we're doing. Well, Pastor, we want our cake and eat it too. No, you ain't. You're going to get ate by the cake. But see, you see how I'm talking though? This is foolishness to the world. This is, what? Who in the world is that? That's a stupid man. Apply your heart to wisdom and see what you get. You'll get understanding. As crazy as this sounds. Yeah, Moses, go about to the Sea of Reeds. What are you going to do? Well, you just hold up your staff. You're going to part the water. I'm going to do what? You're going to part the water. That? Yeah, just hold your hands up. Now, I'm going to be the one that's really parting, but I want everybody to see that you are my custodian. You are my man. And not only that, before you get there, I'm going to put you up before Pharaoh, and I'm going to put horns on your head. So that Pharaoh know that he's not dealing with just Moshe, but he's dealing with a God. Oh, never. I lost him now, boy. I lost him now. I know, and the delights of men are musical instruments. I know it. I got the mindset. Boy, you can't tell me I don't understand his mindset. I comprehend his mindset very well. They speak as wise, I speak as a fool. Because y'all chose the foolishes of this world to confound the wise. You can't talk like I talk unless you've been with y'all. The only thing, your mind be scrambled, but your heart said, that makes sense. Your mind be like, huh? The heart says, man, I don't, but we going that way. Mind be going, wait a minute, let me try to figure this out. Oh, hallelujah. I say y'all's good. Leviticus 10 and 11. Read, Brother Shane.
And that ye may put difference between holy and unholy.
Y'all hear that? That we may put difference between what?
Holy
and what? Unholy. Y'all see my video, right, about the Muslims raping that girl, right? And you look like you are. We gonna rape you. They used to, in their country, women being covered. They out here, woo, wow, wee, look at them. Whole world full of whorehouses. Hey, prostitute everywhere. I'm not a prostitute. You look like one to me. We rape you. Putting the difference between the holy and the profane. How many times I told us, see, it's happening over there first before it gets to here. Europe is always ahead of us in debauchery and hell and everything else. When it comes over here, we magnified. I told you. And what's happening? You've got refugees fleeing from all these countries, and they're going into Germany, all the European westernized countries. Are they not? They're going in there, and what are they having a problem with? Rape. What I tell you years ago, what was going to take place when they get over here? What does the prophet say? The prophet says, and your women will be ravished. They see you, they go, oh, must be holy woman. We leave you alone. And here come Barbie doll. Oh, hey, boys, come on, party. And then America get on here with these stupid idiotic talk show hosts. We can't understand why come they don't understand that that's just wicked what they're doing. Because you can't understand that your wives and your women look like whores, and it's wicked what they're doing. You can't understand that. Well, I'm free. What's your freedom that got you when you got three guys raping you? Did I say it's right? No. But these guys come from a culture. You look like a whore. Or let me go the other way. If it looks like a duck, it quacks like a duck, and it swims like a duck, it's a what? It's a duck. You look like a woman. You act like a woman. You are a woman. You look like a whore. Dress like a whore, you paint your face like a whore, you twist your behind like a whore, you show your breasts like a whore, then you are a
whore.
Simple. Simple. And today, the way they dress, they don't leave nothing for the imagination. Nothing for the imagination. So the culture that we're in is wrong, and what they're doing is wrong, but they don't see it as wrong. Where in the Bible, y'all remember when Judah thought he was going to get a whore? Do y'all remember? Huh? Where in the Bible did he repent for that? He thought he was just going to get a whore. Came back to the land. Did he not? He didn't walk around on his head down. I'm not saying, I tell you, y'all try to go out and get a whore. Because I know how your wicked ass minds work. You're going to be just like that letter we just got finished reading. And don't be coming to ask me or Pastor Carter to lay hands on your funky ass, because we ain't doing that. We're going to bury you with the heathens. Defile our cemetery. But you got to cover all bases, because you know, these bookers big. You don't say it, man. You got to cover it off. You don't cover it off, man. The people like about your Jeez. That's how perverse the generation is. Both men and women. See how far we've fallen. He said there was only going to be a few. Only a few. You see your calling, brother. Not many mighty. Not many wise. Just a few of you. And you're going to despise that? If you're able to even hear. We're coming up out of this. From here we go to the promised land. No doubt about it. Ah, just a figment of your imagination. We're good. I'm going to imagine. It's better than living a perverted dream. Oh, hallelujah. Read, Brother Shane.
And between unclean and clean. And that you may teach the children of Israel all the statutes which Yahweh hath spoken unto them by the hand of Moses.
See, we get in trouble because we teach you the statutes. Isn't that beautiful, though? So we just obey the scriptures. Because the scripture says, Deuteronomy 23:17, read.
There shall be no whore of the daughters of Israel.
Did y'all hear that? There shall be no what?
Whore.
Of the what?
Daughters of Israel.
Read on.
Nor a sodomite of the sons of Israel.
Y'all hear that? Nor a sodomite of the sons of Israel. That's righteous laws. Leviticus 18:22-23, read.
Thou shalt not lie with mankind as with womankind.
Ooh.
It is abomination.
It's a what?
Abomination.
But this world accepts it hook, line, and sinkers. They got a thing out there called the Supreme Court. And the Supreme Court has just flat out said, you know what? We know more than the Creator. We ain't going to wait for all these states to pass the law. We just do a clean sweep for them. You want to marry a man? Go out there and get you one. And learn not the ways of the heathen. Read.
Neither shalt thou lie with any beast to defile thyself or therewith.
They got states in this union right here where it's legal. Bestiality is legal. And then they want to turn around and act like that polygyny is the most perverse, abominable thing that they... See, everything's reversed. It's turned upside down. That which is good is now what? Evil. And that which is evil is now what? Good. And they have gone away backwards. And this perverted mind thinks that it's so right. Read.
Neither shall any woman stand before a beast to lie down thereto. It is confusion.
See, the nations, can you imagine a woman goes out there and she got in her mind, look at that horse. Look at that dog. That's the nations. See, Yah was warning us about the sins of the Canaanites and what these perverse boogers was doing. Now the whole world is just drinking this stuff up like it's just... It is sickness. See, and guess what? People getting mad at us for calling it sickness. You ain't going to muzzle this ox that's traded out the corn. And that's what they want to do, their censorship. They want to try to muzzle us. You ain't muzzling me. Uh-oh. Y'all got this thing so figured out, don't worry about it. They kill me, he'll raise up another one. And he'll make him even more vile in your sight than I was. That's how y'all does things. That's how he does it. See, these people think they know the Father. Huh? Did you finish, Brother Shane? Read Leviticus 11, 7 through 10. Read it fast.
And the swine.
And the what?
And the swine.
Pig.
Though he divide the hoof and be cloven-footed, yet he cheweth not the cud. He is unclean to you.
But we live in a county. They race each other to get to the barbecue joint. The pagans get out of church Sunday and they race to the barbecue joints. They even move their church services up 30 minutes so they can let out 30 minutes earlier than the other church so they can beat them to the barbecue joint. Easter, you'll see this church right here, all of them sitting out front waiting for the sun, the S-U-N, to come up so they can play songs and lift up their hands. Y'all don't remember me showing y'all that on video years ago? Look at these boogers. And such were some of you. But you are washed.
Hallelujah.
That's what the book says. Oh, boy. Mm-mm-mm. See, some of you, you were so hard-headed, you could not listen to nobody but a preacher like me. Couldn't get in touch with your stubborn spirit. You were too hard-headed. So y'all had to bring the hammer. We the hard-headed ones. Read.
Of their flesh shall ye not eat.
You don't do what?
Don't eat.
You don't eat it. That's a delicacy in this country. Read on.
And their carcass shall ye not touch.
Come on.
They are unclean to you. There shall ye eat of all that are in the waters. Whatsoever hath fins and scales in the waters, in the seas, and in the rivers, them shall ye eat.
Now let's see. Does catfish have fins and scales?
No.
What about shrimp?
No.
And they eat that stuff like... You ever been a Red Lobster and see that thing, crab? You look at that thing and go, uh-uh. That booger might jump off the plate, man. Can you imagine going to a restaurant and seeing a fish bowl full of crab? I want that. Damn pagan, salivating for the very thing that y'all told you, don't do, stay away from, don't even eat it. And they got the same book we got. Same book. Read.
And all that have not fins and scales in the seas and in the rivers, of all that move in the waters and of any living thing which is in the waters, they shall be an abomination unto you.
See the reason why we're greater than all the other nations? We got laws. We have laws. Here's the transgender cross-dressing abominations to these soft sissy men. Look at this one. 1 Corinthians 6:9, read.
Know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of Yah?
You hear that? It's one thing to say unrighteous, so now we have to identify what unrighteous is. And now he's going to tell us what unrighteous is. Read.
Be not deceived, neither fornicators.
A fornicator, someone that is unrighteous. Read.
Nor idolaters.
Nor what?
Idolaters.
Adulterers. No. You forget idolaters. Worshiping idols. And some of you worship yourself. You forgot about that idol, didn't you? Read on.
Nor adulterers. Nor effeminate.
Adulterers and effeminate. See, we got strict laws. You leave your brother's wife alone. You leave his wives alone. And then here's the kick. Here's the big one. Nor in feminine. And soft to the touch. Soft to the touch, men. In feminine. Men that act more effeminate than women do. Y'all said they ain't going in. Do you never, you mean tell me y'all go outside these gates and you don't never see effeminate men? They're crawling. They're everywhere. They're like flies. I can't help it. So sometimes Sister Carol just be elbowing me hard. They come out there. I mean, pow. And she's not protecting the feminine man. What she's trying to do is wake me up because she know I'm going to say something. Read.
Nor abusers of themselves with mankind, nor thieves, nor covetous, nor drunkards, nor revilers, nor extortioners shall inherit the kingdom of Yah. And such were some of you. But ye are washed. But ye are sanctified. But ye are justified.
See,
in the name.
I don't care, but one of those categories were you. Yeah, one of them were you. See, now look what the Father's done. He done washed us. By the word. That's why he said such were some of you. Now he's going to wash us. And then he says you're sanctified. He done washed you and now you're sanctified. Is that not beautiful? I'm happy. I tell you, man, I fit a lot of those categories. Sure is nice to be clean. Yes. Oh, you washed in the blood, in that soul cleansing blood of the Lamb. Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? I am. Amazing, isn't it? Boy, y'all is good, isn't it?
Look at him looking.